I remember 70, 71 was the beginning of the blaxploitation films with Shaft, Sweetback, Cotton Comes to Harlem, and it birthed many future black movie stars, such as Ron O'Neill, Fred Williamson, Calvin Lockhart, Pam Grier, Billy Dee Williams, Max Julian, Richard Pryor and the Mac, Bernie Casey, Brenda Sykes and Jim Brown, Isaac Hayes, Memphis's own was Truck Turner, Yaphet Kotto, and then Tamra Dobson, Cleopatra Jones, and again, Shaft, Sidney Poitier, Lola Falana, Jim Brown, and then William Marshall in Blackula, Roscoe Orman in Willie Dynamite, Anisette Chase, Sidney Poitier, and Bill Cosby, Paul Winfield, Ken Norton, and then Diane Carroll and James Earl Jones, some of our great actors of our time. Boy, I remember all the great gathering places we had, starting off in Orange Mound at the W.C. Handy Theater. I don't know if you all remember the old Tammy Rock concert in 1964 that featured James Brown and the Famous Flames. We would go down there every Monday night just to see James Brown do his fabulous footwork, slide across the screen, and then one-line songs, just one-word songs. Please, please, please. And then the first verse was one word. The second verse was one word. James made $1 million selling.
Honey, please don't go.
I mean, watch. Check y'all. Watch him now. Watch him. He's going to take the mic, grab back. He's going to grab it and go. One, two, three, four. Bam! Hit it, James. Come on, somebody. Put the cape on him. Put the cape on. Come on, put the cape on. Carry him on out like he in the spirit. James Brown in the Tammy Rock concert at the W.C. Handy. Don't know if y'all remember, but I sure do. And then later on, as we got a chance to travel outside of Orange Mound, went to the Malco. You remember sitting up in the nosebleed section? We had to sit in the balcony because we were black. The Lowe's Theater on Union. You remember that? I remember the Memorial Stadium, many football games against Christian Brothers. Of course, we graduated from the Ellis Auditorium, the Coliseum, where we spent so many great concerts. I remember James Brown coming. James Brown is coming to town. You remember that? You remember the Jackson 5 coming to the Coliseum on a Sunday evening? Those were our Beatles. The Tempting Temptations, November 70. Dennis Edwards had just replaced David Ruffin. Sly and the Family Stone. How many of y'all remember old Sly? Larry Graham came out of the Sly and Family Stone group. I remember Coliseum wrestling with Sputnik Monroe, Jackie and Roughhouse Fargo, Tojo Yamamoto, Al and Don Green, Jerry the King Lawler. Wow. Remember basketball, Memphis State basketball with our heroes, Larry Finch. And then playing for Memphis State for four great years up against UCLA. Larry Finch and big deal, Ronnie Robinson. Those are some great days. We watched them as they represented Melrose with Memphis State. You remember the old rides at the fairgrounds? Remember the tumblebug and the zipping, pipping roller coaster? Do you remember the old merry-go-round? Oh man, the carousel and the scrambler and the paratrooper. And then the spider, and just so many great rides that we had at the old fairgrounds. How I miss the fairgrounds. Our kids will never have what we have. We had great royalty at our school, represent our school very well. I remember the coronation night when Joyce Marie Harvey was crowned as our Miss Melrose. Clinton Holman was crowned as Mr. Melrose. My best friend Robert Winfield, alternate, and best friend Lois Bolden to Mr. and Miss Melrose. Peggy Brown was Miss Senior. Glenda Walker was alternate to Miss Senior. Rosalind Strong was crowned football homecoming queen in our senior year. Margaret Reed was crowned basketball homecoming queen. Evelyn Laverne Dixon was crowned Miss ROTC. Golden Wildcats class of 71, the football team, had a great year that year. I remember we started the season off with a loss 12-7 on September the 12th against Chattanooga Howard. We traveled there and lost that game, but that game helped us. Kenneth Lowhill was a senior halfback. And then Friday, September the 18th, we played against Booker T. Washington and defeated them 28-4. Nathaniel Pilgrim, co-captain and fullback of the Melrose football team. 28-4. We crushed them, as the paper said. And then we had a thrill against Southside. I remember that at Crump Stadium. 12-8, William Crutcher getting the winning pass. 12-8, September the 24th. Both teams were undefeated at the time. Lewis Davis was in the backfield. Also, Fugaboon, we called him Fugaboon John Batts, 10th grade quarterback in the Melrose team, 36-12 over Northside. Senior player, James Snatcher Thompson, who was split in, one of the fastest people in town. On October the 9th, we went up against Central, defeated them 14-6. And then Bill Larimore, the one white boy, was our nose guard and a senior. I remember this picture with Snatcher snatching a leg, a chicken leg. And then October the 17th, we played against Hillcrest and defeated Hillcrest. Both teams were undefeated at that time. And we defeated them 6-0 on October the 16th. Thomas Johnson was a senior guard on the team that year. And then we played Frazier 18-0. William Crutcher was tight end that year, senior tight end. It's all for one and one for all in Melrose. And they featured a story on Bill Larimore in the commercial appeal. And we defeated Whitehaven 14-7, October the 31st. Go Wildcats. And then John Greer was a senior fullback on that team. We're going in the order of the yearbook as the seniors appeared. Melrose 53, over Tech 0, November the 6th, 1970. Terry Matthews was a defensive back. Melrose's rolling bus nears its last roadblock. Remember playing Carver and the rain fell that night in our homecoming? November the 13th, 1970, we defeated them 6-0. And then once again, they featured John Batts, sophomore quarterback. Freddie Edwards was a senior receiver for the Melrose Golden Wildcats. Then we went to the semifinals and played Chattanooga East Ridge. Beat them 26-6 on November the 20th. And now it's time to move on to the championship game. And during that time, they did an article with Nathaniel Pilgrim, "This Good Guy Wears a White Helmet." Ricky Hudson, our friend and committee member, was the center that year. Melrose marches Memphis flag to the state title game. And oh, we ran into a roadblock. I remember that night in the championship game, November 26th, 1970, we lost, unfortunately, 36-0. But what a great experience and a great year. Go Wildcats. Nobody defeated us in the city of Memphis in that year. Our record was 10-2.
But you know it's my life too. And if you throw it away,